Hi, I'm Ryan. I work in the media industry, and I've lived in China for almost 4 years now. 2021 marks the 100th anniversary of the founding of the Communist Party of China. And during those 100 years, its members have grown from a few dozen to over 95 million strong. Living in China, some of my friends and colleagues are party members. Now you might be curious, what exactly are these people like? So to help you get a better understanding, I've invited other foreigners who also live in China to go and visit young party members through various careers in an attempt to paint a clearer picture by better getting to know their life and their work. We hope to discover who these people really are. And I personally hope that these experiences help foreigners in China and abroad better understand this country and its people. I'm here in the Honghe Mountain Valley region of Yunnan, where one man and his team are trying to do something incredible for this area. Where most people might see a wasteland, Dr. Zhao is spending his life towards achieving his vision of a future paradise for this area. Let's go and give him a visit.
Hey, Doctor. You know, you're good.
Take a job.
I'm good.
Hey, Dr. Zhao.
Hello.
Hey, 你好。
你好。
Hey, 你好。Nice to meet you.
Oh, it is quite an impressive view you have up here.
Yes, it's difficult to find that place.
Very, very difficult.
我是赵高俊，是中国科学院昆明植物所的一名研究助理，主要从事干热虎骨的树种筛选和生态修复工作。
What are you guys doing here?
我们现在是要看看这里面有多少个种物种，然后每个物种它的密度能达到多大，然后我来了解这个地方的这个地上的这个对，平均就是地上的植被这种，要寻找一些方法来恢复这个退化的这些生态系统。这个地方被称为干热虎骨，就留在 Dry Hot Valley。
Oh, yeah.Yeah, I read about that doing some research. It definitely lives up to its name. It's very dry and very hot.
这个干热虎骨呢，它是一个在中国西南是一个非常普遍的一个形象。生态系统它是非常脆弱的，它的恢复是非常困难的，是现在实际上面临的一个难题。一年只有两个季节，一个就叫雨季，一个叫旱季。这个地方它冬天的时候，它的温度都可以达到12度到15度这个概念，
温度比较高，就是会导致很多植物在这个地方。不能生长。
Yeah, okay. What do I need to do?
Maybe you can help me.
Okay.
To collect the soil.
I can hold bags.
After getting a look at how barren the soil is here, I'm very curious as to get a look behind the scenes and see what he and his team are doing to try to combat this and make this place more green and hospitable.
It was just on a rock under some plants.
这个要捞回去，不然它会死掉的。老虎山地未来给那点水喝。
There's no mom.
哎，那个地方呢，就是我们的这个基地。
Will everyone be surprised when we bring this guy?
Yes.
我们回来了，还请了一个小羊。
Oh, okay. Go ahead.
He is my teacher.
Oh,
professor.
Hello.
Hello.
Where are you from?
From Florida.
Oh, nice place. I have been there.
Really?
Yeah.
What part?
Gainesville.
Gainesville.
Yeah.
That's my university. That's where I went to school.
They are very famous for tropic conservation. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So, right, it's dinner time.
Sure. Where can I put this little guy?
Put this.
Just put it here first.
Put this.
Put him on the ground?
Yes.
Okay. Dr. Zhao.
You had the tool.
Hey, good morning.
Hello.Hey, good morning. Okay, hey, is my partner.
Oh, hi there. Ryan.
Aurel, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
现在我们追求的生态修复，不管你要做什么乔木、灌木还是草本，就是我们现在要选树来试地。相对就是简单来说，就是我们现在要找树种，找不同的树种。
Hey, guy, look over there.
Where? Oh, it's great.
There is some local bombax tree around.
Oh, a local one?
Local bombax tree.
So which tree is it? This one?
Yes. 这个呢就是 bombax ceiba。我们也种了城市种了很多的这个树种，用于这个地方的生态修复，作为一个优势的一个乔木树种。
Gotcha.
但是在后面就是我们发现它这个名序，这个 fable is fly.
Okay, it's too hard to keep.
Yes.
Okay.
找树种呢，我们分两条路走。一条路呢，就是说我们就在本地来找这些当地的优秀树种。Harry, we're together. Okay.
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 I'm going up too? Yeah?
Okay.
Okay.
撑起来我踩这个树叶子啊。Wow, it's very cool.
Yeah. I bet you want one of these now to collect your samples from now on.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, look, a bird's nest.
第二个呢，就是我们还引进了一些非洲的这些植被，因为非洲的它有大面积的这个扫亡了植被，它这个跟干燥湖泊的气候条件是一样的，所以说我们就引进外面的一些植被，就是说还有爪哇木棉。
Hey guys, come here. I'm seeing some farmers collecting the tree around here.
All right.
Okay, we are coming. Rain, 你看到对面那些木棉树了吗
？Yeah, yeah. It looks different than the local species we saw.
是的，是的，你说的很对。这个树种呢，它叫爪哇木棉，这个是10年前我们从印度尼西亚引种过来的。然后呢，我通过我们的培育了以后呢，我们把这个树种免费的提供给这个当地的这个农民，种在他们这个田间地埂，还有就是屋前屋后。然后果实里面有很多的腥味，这个腥味可以给他们提供一定的经济价值。本地的那个攀枝花，它果实成熟以后，它会爆开，飞掉。然后这个呢，它就不会飞掉。这个给当地的这些农民呢，就提供这个采收起来就非常的容易。
If you don't mind me asking, how many of these fruit will you collect during a year, and what do you end up selling them all for?
我们农民嘛，做了就收到一年可能15000多个的那种，全嘛大概可能4500多一点吧。
Yeah, so not a small amount. Yeah, yeah, that's a pretty good little haul for collecting some fruit. So I see here we have like grass, some bushes, some bigger trees. So this is your target for your ecological restoration project?
哦，是的，你很聪明。这个机构的生态修复是我们对干热湖泊修复的一个终极目标。
我感觉这边待的最久的就是徐老师跟我吧，有时候都是徐老师说你赶快回去了，不然嘛你媳妇都不要你了。其实从这里去昆明也不是太远，他们都说了我现在回昆明都是出差，我是虹口，我是这个地方的人了，我回昆明出差。
So we spent the entire day up and down the mountain searching for bombax samples, but now.We're headed back to the mountain center, hopefully for some very much needed rest.
我呢来这个农村，小的时候家里面的所有活计我都干，就是种玉米啊，种土豆啊，家里面还要养猪养牛，全部一个人干了。所以说，其实小时候这个经历，其实对我的影响是非常大的。
What are we doing?
加油。
We're adding.
Oh, adding gas.
Aurel, how long have you known Dr. Zhao?
I've known Dr. Zhao for the last 1 year. He really opened the door for me and also introduced me to this new environment. And he helped me a lot for the field work, farm work.
Dr. Zhao, it almost looks like the heat like doesn't faze him at all.
Yeah, you know, Dr. Zhao is used to that.You know,
yeah,
and which for him is quite easy, but for new people like us, we need to have some encouragement.
Yeah,
and I got those encouragement from him.
我在干热湖泊已经待了11年左右吧。最开始来的时候是其实是真的很绝望，因为第一次来到那么贫瘠的地方，以前的生态是没有这么好的。其实我们来的时候其实是我师弟啊，我师兄他们都一起来的，他们就感觉这个地方存活不下去了，就那活不下去了，在这个地方他们无法待下去。但是我感觉我这个地方呢，
我感觉还行吧，我感觉没那么严重吧。那时候所以说，我师弟他们跟我来做实验都是，我还煮饭给他们吃，还给他们做好所有的仪器，他们都是在办公室坐着等我。
Dr. Chow, what about you? How did you get interested in this field?
然后在我考上大学的时候呢，然后我父亲陪着我去拿了这个通知书，然后他非常的生气，然后他还以为我这个录取通知书是假的，然后后面呢他问我这个是学来干嘛的，当时我也不知道是干嘛的，所以说我跟他说可能是栽树的吧。然后他跟我说你就不用去读书了，他说你我教你栽怎么栽树，他说。然后我最后就决定跟着徐老师继续搞这个干扰湖泊这个生态修复这条路，但是中间呢还是感觉人生非常遗憾的一个事情，就是我刚刚上研究生的时候，我的妈妈就走掉了，所以说我当时其实是很难过啊，一年我都没缓过来那时候。
Do they now, right? Like now, do they understand? Now they're like, oh wow, this is very important. Yeah. You were born in a mountainous region, and now you're here working in another one. Is there any difference between the two?
那时候的大山跟现在的大山，我感觉还是两个不同的概念的大山吧。以前的大山可能是一种控制或者一种性质，就感觉自己要走出这个地方。后面就是读书，读书再读书，这是一种思想的一种转变。我个人觉得，现在的大山我感觉是一种奉献，或者是一种精神。现在大山并不是现在，因为我也去过城市了，但现在的大山是因为我想着我要把我学的这些东西再应用于这，再把它应用在这个大山里面。我是在2013年6月18号光荣的成为一名共产党员，和一些优秀的党员的一些接触过程中呢，我就发现这些共产党员他们有一个共同的特点，就是他们说的少做的多。我也想用这种要求来要求自己，这种徐老师给我们说过的一句话我记得非常的清楚，就是作为一名中国科学院的科学家，国家哪里需要我们，我们就要去到哪里，我们就要去到国家最艰难的地方。我现在33岁，我想我会继续在这个地方待下去，义不容辞。